Now we are going to study about oxygen. So oxygen atomic symbol is O, but we know that it is diatomic. That means two atoms of oxygen exist together forming a molecule, that is O2. And if we look for the atomic number of oxygen is 8. The electronic configuration, that is the arrangement of electrons, is 2-6. And here is an atomic model in which we know that this is nucleus and these are shells. So how many protons, neutrons and electrons are there? Because atomic number is 8, so protons are 8. And we know that atoms are neutral. So that means electron is 8 and neutron even is 8 because its mass number is 16 and atomic number is 8. So we can actually calculate electron, proton, neutrons by making use of atomic and mass number. So this is the atomic model for the oxygen atom. Now, how the oxygen was discovered, like who was the one volunteer who discovered oxygen and who named it? So there was a scientist, Joseph Priestley, who in 1774 discovered this gas. How? He actually burnt this thing, carried out the decomposition of HGO in presence of sun rays. That means the mercurous oxide. He carried out the decomposition of mercurous oxide in presence of sun rays, and it leads to the formation of a new kind of gas, that is O2. And then in 1789, there was a scientist, Anton Lavoisier, who named this gas as oxygen. So this is how the oxygen was discovered. Now, we know that oxygen is present almost everywhere. So we'll see that where its percentage is more. On Earth's surface, it is 50% of Earth's surface. It is present in air, forming 21% volume of air. It is present in water bodies, now forming 89.9% weight of water. Human body, it forms 2/3 mass of the body is formed of water, and it is also found in animal and plants, but the composition is actually variable. So it is found almost, you can see, everywhere the oxygen exists. Now how the oxygen can be prepared? So we can prepare in lab by using the raw material manganese dioxide, hydrogen peroxide. I'll write the names along. Manganese dioxide, hydrogen peroxide, and for this we need apparatus like this. So what is this? This is a round bottom flask, this is a thistle funnel, this is a tube, right, and this is a trough which contains the water, and this is an inverted tube. Now what we do is we take MnO2 crystals in it. We take manganese dioxide in the round bottom flask, and with the help of this dropper we are pouring H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide, drop wise into this round bottom flask. Then what happens, this H2O2 get decomposed in the presence of MnO2. Here MnO2 act as a catalyst. What is catalyst? Catalyst is that which just make the reaction happen or just increase the rate of reaction without undergoing any change in itself. So this is a catalyst. What is a catalyst? A substance which increases the rate without undergoing any change. So MnO2 will act as a catalyst and will help in the decomposition of H2O2. So H2O2 in presence of MnO2 decomposes to form water and oxygen. This oxygen gas passes from this tube into this trough, and due to downward displacement, it is because it is lighter than water, so it gets collected over water. So this is how the oxygen can be prepared in the lab by the decomposition of H2O2 in presence of catalyst MnO2. There are certain other substances also which you can make use of if you need to prepare oxygen. We can carry out the decomposition of KClO3, that is potassium chlorate, same in the presence of catalyst MnO2. So we'll get KCl and O2. So this can also be employed in labs for preparing the oxygen. But otherwise, the popular method for preparing the oxygen in the lab is by making use of manganese dioxide as a catalyst and carrying out the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. So that means this is a basic intro of oxygen. I think you got it. Now we are going to start with the physical properties of the oxygen, and then we'll take into consideration the chemical properties, because we want to see that how it reacts with different substances.